Day one, I head south towards LA on Interstate 5, but I wanted to take a scenic route. My first stop was in the rice fields opposite the Sacramento National Wildlife Refuge. Here, the rice was nearly ready for harvest. My next detour took me west on Highway 20 to Highway 16. I wanted to take a look at the Berryessa Snow Mountain National Monument. Tule elk were relocated here in 1927 by the California Department of Fish and Game. Passing through little west side towns, you're never sure what you might find. By this time, it was noon, so I headed into Sacramento. I stopped at Leatherby's for a huckleberry shake, and it was good. I continued my long drive down Interstate 5 to Southern California, where I was greeted by traffic. Day two was spent visiting family. I had to bring a gift, so I stopped at one of the, quote, best donut shops, unquote, in Orange County. Day three, I headed across the desert with a few stops along the way. In Hemet, there used to be a menagerie and a place for retired zoo animals. Only a few animals are left. It's that time of year in Hemet. I headed into the mountains for the Santa Rosa, San Jacinto National Monument. It's late September, and there's a variety of plants still in bloom. I tried to go to the Sand to Snow National Monument, but the road was closed. People who live in the desert like their sculptures. Driving over to Amboy, I tried unsuccessfully to find a sign for the Mojave Trails National Park. Near the border was this monument to General Patton's Camp Ibis. Heading north on Highway 93, I tried to find a sign for the Avi Qua Ami National Monument. Day four was spent visiting some of my old stomping grounds. Thank you. These wild burros were at Lake Mead. I don't think they liked the bicyclist. At Valley of Fire, they have some wonderful picnic shelters and shade resources. I took the spur road out to White Domes. At the crest of the first hill, two bighorn sheep crossed the road in front of me. returning from the White Domes, two more bighorn sheep crossed the road at the same place as the other two. Another one of my old stomping grounds was the area that is now Gold Butte National Monument. On day five, I plan to drive through the Tushar Mountains to see fall colors and head up to the high country. The road tops out at 11,470 feet. Even here at elevation, plants are still in bloom. Heading east, I bypass Bryce Canyon to go to the Escalante Grand Staircase National Monument. Day 6, I return to Boulder to take the Burr Trail. Thank you. Entering Calf Paw Reef National Park, I headed down the Burr Trail switchbacks. In the main section of the park, I drove down the Capitol Gorge. Day 7, I returned home. I stopped at Sevier Lakebed to scout out a location for the upcoming eclipse. It rained all the way across Nevada. Driving down from Austin, I looked back to see the snow on the mountains. Near Fallon, the sand flats were covered with water.